I started primary school in my hometown, Kwewebitifi. I went to the Presbyterian B primary school, you know, from class one up to three. I didn't go to the nursery as people do, you know. I went straight to class one because I started school at age five, you know, so I went straight to class one, you know. And I remember my first test I had, I was fourth. My next test, I was first. You know what I mean? You need brutal. But I didn't wear BA before class one. So I went through that, came to Accra, joined mum, you know, auntie, the Kedri Chumwa Gladys, the best mum God will bless anyone with, you know. And I continued school from Kotobabi 3, went through all the Saito schools up to Harvard College at Kokomimle, did my sixth form at Superstar Study Center. And then I had to do the street university and had my PhD on the streets, became a rapper, and then eventually found my passion, reggae dancehall music, and became a reggae dancehall artist. And yes, put out a single, Sweetie Sweetie, with Reggie Rockstone when he was preparing his first album. So I would say that in Ghana, I can confidently say that I was the first to put out an authentic, you know, people had made efforts before me, people had tried stuff, but well, it all sounded like the same high life thing, you know. We had that problem then. But I got it right. I finally put out a dancehall song that was authentic and could match up anything that came from wherever in the world, you know, from here in Ghana. And after that successful single, Sweetie Sweetie, I had my first radio job, you know, Mr. Wilson, out of Sky Power 93.5 in Takoradi. We met through General Marcus, and he discovered that I was the guy behind that Sweetie Sweetie song, and he went crazy. I remember that day, he carried me on his back. You know what I mean? Mr. Wilson is my number one fan. Boy believes in me like Jesus Christ. You know, so he gave me my first radio job. And for the records, I've never applied for a job. You know, a job comes to me all the time. That's one thing God has blessed me with. So this man was like, look, I'm setting up a radio station in Takoradi, and I would want you to come and, you know, run a reggae show on my radio station. And I said, the closest I've come to radio is being in a radio studio for an interview when I released my Sweetie Sweetie song. I've never done this. And he said, you know what? I know you can do it. Just come along with me. Let's go to Takoradi and do this. I went to Takoradi. And in a matter of like a week or two, Ruta had become a household name in the whole of the western and central regions of Ghana. You know, from there, I had the opportunity to work with the same company when they got enough money and bought another radio station in Kumasi, and I had to go and assist one of the partners to establish that. So I was in Kumasi for 5 years, between 2000 and 2005, doing Ash FM. And then after 5 years, I wanted to challenge myself some more. So I got pushed, actually, by Hot FM when it was starting in Accra. So I was shifted down here to Accra, you know what I mean? And from there, I moved on. Then the TV3 music job ran into me. That's what I say. Well, that'd be like Yobi. Because actually, I'd been to TV3. I'd started managing artists. I'd been to TV3 to lobby for an artist, for one of my artists, you know, to perform on Music. They had gone for like a 5 month break or so, and they were returning. The show was coming back. And I'm sure they had a problem with who to host the show. They already had two ladies, Josie and Stacy, and Bola, who used to be with them, wasn't coming. So they had a problem with who was going to be the male presenter with the ladies. And one of my artists, Eves dropped the conversation that was going on between staff of TV3. So he hinted me. So from there, I mean, after the discussions, I called Park with Siakom and he said, wow, you know, you come here all the time and I think of discussing this thing with you, but it just, can you come back tomorrow morning so we talk about it? I went to see him the next day. You know, he was like, go on the stage, let's see what happens. Give me an intro. Then I flow an intro. Give me an outro. I flow an outro. Give me a link. I do that. He said, well, you have a job. So that was it. First thing he told me was, Charlie, you fine. You, Charlie, the way they stand on the stage, and they feel the way they look for, you know. Yeah, one of those guys that God is blessed with. You know, the things money can't buy.